Imagine, you drive out of town at night, you run out of fuel, and then immediately get approached by a homeless man. Kind of reminds you of some kind of horror movie, right? But then what happened to them both shocked even me. This is how it all started. 27-year-old American Kate McClure was driving from New Jersey to Philadelphia. Nothing special. When suddenly, she ran out of gas and got stranded in the middle of the road. You'd think, who doesn't this happen to? However, the situation was made worse by the fact that this happened on a poor section of the highway, not to mention late at night. A lonely girl, in the dark, and in the middle of a highway with no one around to ask for help. Isn't the luckiest day, huh? Kate was trying to work on finding a solution, growing in distress with each passing minute, when suddenly, a homeless man approached her. With the stress fogging her mind up, Kate didn't even stop to wonder what a homeless man could possibly be doing on a deserted road at this time. He went up to the girl and simply asked if she was okay. Kate naively trusted the stranger and explained the situation. Johnny Bobbitt, the homeless man's name, advised her to stay in her car before he went off somewhere. As it turned out, a little bit later, he went to the nearest gas station, bought gas on his last $20, and had even helped pour it into the tank. At that time, the girl had no cash with her and couldn't pay the man, but she did promise to help him, and she kept her word. Together with her boyfriend, Mark D'Amico, she shared an amazing story on social networking sites and organized a fundraiser on the GoFundMe platform to help Johnny get back on his feet. The couple had initially planned to raise $10,000 so that the man could rent a place out and live on the money for several months before finding a job. However, people were so softened by the homeless man's actions that they continued to donate money even after reaching $10,000. About 14,000 people took part in the call to action, and eventually, $402,000 had been gathered in a mere 3 weeks. It looked like a success. Everyone was happy. A few months passed, and some donors were very curious to see how Johnny Bobbitt was living now on those $400,000. It's pretty much the wildest dream any homeless person could ever dream of. So then, what did he do with the money that he was donated, they wondered. This is when people began to find out that Johnny was once again homeless. How could that be? A little bit later, Johnny gives an interview to one of the newspapers in which he reveals some unexpected details. He says that some money was indeed given to him, but he never actually did see the whole amount. He accuses the couple of deception. Kate, in her turn, explains that the money that he spent was actually spent on drugs and that she decided not to give up the rest of the money until the man was put in rehab. The situation was quite confusing, so the GoFundMe website hired lawyers to help with the case. Then, the story, which was received as a miracle of human generosity, crumbled to dust. It turns out that the highway rescue story was completely fabricated from start to finish. In fact, the trio had been conspiring to think up and spread a sentimental story that would give people a reason to donate. The lawyers had also found out that these people all knew each other at least a month prior to the GoFundMe campaign. The couple had indeed paid the homeless man the money that they agreed on, and if he had kept quiet, the fraudulent scheme would have never seen the light. However, as they say, greed does one in, and the homeless man wanted much more than what he was given, ruining everything. The investigation had also revealed most of the money spent by Kate and Mark went towards a BMW, luxury resorts, expensive things, and Mark's gaming addiction. Now, the couple faces up to 5 years in prison and huge fines of up to $250,000 each, along with returning the full donation amount to the GoFundMe website, which, by the way, already paid off all the donors who ended up being the real victims in this story. As for the homeless man, Johnny, well, he got off with a 5-year probationary period. Leave a comment below telling us what you think about this story. Have you ever caught yourself in a similar situation where you helped someone and then uncovered a lie?